We're here in actually one of my friend's restaurants as well in Knightsbridge. Lots of nice people here. Everyone's super friendly. Amazing gifting. So now I feel thoroughly, thoroughly spoiled for a Monday. Normally Monday shouldn't be this good. So I'm feeling very blessed. I think there's guys upstairs who have these amazing scar healing creams, and I had a major scar on my shoulder from an operation I had, and I've been trying everything to get rid of it, and they promised me that this is the product. So if it works, I will go back and I will endorse the product for absolutely free, because I'm desperate to get rid of my scar. Aside from that, also some very nice young ladies gave me a very good hand massage and got some cool shoes. So I mean, the list goes on and on. It's a tough life, guys, really. Products I swear by, yes, Dove shower gel. It costs about £3, but it's better than any other shower gel. It's funny how the simple things in life always work out being the best. What else do I absolutely adore? God, I can't think off the top of my head. A lot of things. So at the moment, my sunglass stable, Taylor Morris, is going great. Like, the kind of global distribution of that's really kind of increased, and you know, I have to kind of pinch myself from having it all go so well. And then we've got some really cool TV stuff lined up for this year. So yeah, looking forward to making something a bit more hard-hitting than people otherwise used to.
Is that something that's important to you, to kind of, you know, move away from doing something that's, you know, entertaining, but maybe something that's got a little bit more substance behind it?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's what everyone, well, that's what I certainly want to do, but you have to earn the right to get there. You know, top broadcasters in this country have been there for a while, and it's not in, you know, the new scheme of things where you can have quite a meteoric rise and then go off and make something serious. You've got to earn the right to get there and prove that you're not just a celebrity or reality star, but a broadcaster. So, you know, something kind of like how Stephen Fry's done over the course of his whole career, and, you know, Richard E. Grant. So these are the people whose kind of careers I'm trying to emulate eventually. So yeah, let's hope that with lots of concerted effort, good research, that we can make a really cool documentary that everyone's going to engage with and want to watch.
It's fantastic to have been part of a show like Made in Chelsea that was pioneering in a new genre, in a sense, with constructed reality. I'm curious, though, as you sort of try and move on from that and, like you say, establish yourself as a serious broadcaster, is it hard to distinguish yourself from the kind of persona that the show's created around the people that took part in it?
Yeah, I think it's a very fair question. I think that everyone, if they're on a very hit show and you're most associated with something, it's essentially hard to move away from that. You know, speak to the guys who worked on Friends. I'm not saying Made in Chelsea is anywhere near as Friends, but you know, you all know them as like Joey, Ross and Chandler. And when they want to go off and do something else, it's difficult. So yeah, it's a difficult transition to make. And I think there's a bit of an umbrella term amongst people who work in reality TV that they're all, you know, not particularly intelligent or capable, but you know, I've got a first from university and 5 A's at A-level, so, you know, I'm used to putting in the hard work to get where I want to be, and that's what it's all about for me.
I mean, that's a fair analogy, but I guess the one distinction between Friends and Made in Chelsea is that the people on Friends were playing characters, whereas the perception was, at least, that the people on Made in Chelsea are being themselves and it's your real lives.
Yes, the perception is that way. But, you know, I think the reality to reality TV is quite questionable at times. I think if you want to make a fly-on-the-wall documentary, you make a fly-on-the-wall documentary. Made in Chelsea's a, you know, dramatic entertainment. And, you know, it's constructed reality, dramality, whatever you want to call it. But, you know, at the center of it, there has to be confrontation and resolution. And, you know, unless you're putting together a hugely confrontational bunch of people, you might not necessarily always get that result. But, you know, I think whenever I was on Made in Chelsea, I was myself. And I think that often people, that's what they want to see. They want to see my opinion on things, or they might do. But, you know, I think we've all got a way of looking at things. And I think that, you know, I'm an observant person. So I hope that I can translate my natural enthusiasm for the subjects I'll be talking on to the people watching.